This course is DEA 6040, Future Bodycraft, and it is a course on creating on-skin interfaces, or we can also call it smart tattoos, and also electronic textiles. So I think a more general way to think about it is basically wearable interfaces that are soft and very, very close to the body. So I think innovation for the type of work that my lab does and that I try to embody in teaching is, I think, really thinking about how you can provide like a glimpse of a possible future for the people around you, and then to actually make a tangible artifact, right, to help people have a glimpse of this possible future. We had our final presentations yesterday afternoon. So there are in total 11 projects, and it went really well. Each of the students, they presented the final on-body interfaces they created via Zoom. A couple of them were pandemic themed. So for example, one student created a wristband that would pinch you to give this feeling of a handshake during Zoom meetings. Two students, they made like a mask.
It is a like interactive mask that's coupled with a weave that's attached to the skin. The user will be able to input different emojis based on the different keys. And then this will output onto the LED matrix, which is on the mask.
I was very impressed with the students. I was very proud of them. In a typical semester, we would teach this in the shop in human ecology, and it would be like a very studio environment, and we could talk to each other and, you know, work through the materials together. And so to provide like an equal learning experience, what I decided to do was to create a kit of around the 30 different materials for the five labs that we would have. And so we would, you know, package them in their individual boxes, and we would either ship it to the students who were remote or to have the students who were in Ithaca to come pick it up. So each person, they could essentially complete their labs at home. I think, you know, with like so much technology, social media, it's really about like, you know, speed and doing things very quickly. But now having these exercises with the students working at home with their hands, some of them are very intricate. So it requires really slowing down and kind of really engaging with materials. And I think especially with the weaving exercise, a lot of students just told me that they really enjoyed it and it was stress relieving. And we call it slow technology, or the ability to think about like, you know, how you can engage with devices and technology in a different way that isn't always constantly consuming you. I think that's something very important also, I think, that I wanted the students to kind of just reckon with this course is the controversy. When something goes on the skin, you'll quickly see it's very important to consider different skin tones. There's also a lot of cultural connotations behind tattooing, putting things on your body. It means very different things in different cultures.
I started thinking about Native American history, different tribes in Africa, that's like the Kao tribe in Ethiopia, and how they used to wear face masks or like face paint, and the face paint had different cultural significance.
I think initially I was very unsure if I should actually make these kits and ship them out. Like another way to do it was just get like a seminar style course where we would read and papers and discuss together, right? And however, I did find it important that students were actually able to make these devices. It really helped with their understanding. But I think, you know, in the final critique sessions before their final presentation, there were several instances where I really wish I could have been able to feel some of the devices they're making to give more precise feedback. But I think that is a big part of what gets lost with remote learning. I definitely spend a lot of time just kind of pondering how I would plan this course for fall. And I think what really helped me was, you know, just kind of thinking about like what it means on a more global context, right? To have to teach this course remotely. And I can't remember who said this quote. I don't know if it's Obama or something, but there's this quote called like, you know, like no crisis should be wasted. And so I was like, if I will have to teach this class during a pandemic, then let's go big or go home, essentially.